Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Karen Puzzles. Today, I'm going to be talking about all of the puzzles that I did over Christmas. You can see here this giant stack. I actually saved all of them all put together so that I can show them to you. And they're all just separated here by foam core. So I did 13 puzzles over Christmas. And if you watched my videos from before Christmas, you know that basically every year I work myself super hard, you know, leading up to Christmas. And then I just need a break and I just need to do nothing but jigsaw puzzles. So that's what I did. And I thought about ranking them by how much I liked them. But the thing is, when it's like my own holiday, I am only gonna choose to do puzzles that I know I'm going to like. So that would have been a really boring video because I just would have been like, this is the one I liked the least, but I still loved it. So instead, I thought I would rank them by difficulty. We have a bunch of different brands represented here, some new brands that I've never talked about on this channel before, so I'm really excited to tell you about them. And also, you might notice that I'm using a different camera. I got myself a brand shiny new camera, and I felt like I had to put on extra makeup this morning because it can see like every detail of my face now. But I just wanted to do like a simple video to, you know, test out the camera and kind of get a feel for it. So yeah, let's get into it. Let's start talking about puzzles. All right, starting from the easiest puzzle that I did, this is the puzzle Herstory Museum by Gallison. This was actually a Christmas gift from my sister, and I put it together on Christmas, like on Christmas afternoon. I did it without looking at the box, but because there's so much of like a grid in this design, you know, and the different images are broken out so cleanly, it really didn't take long. It wasn't that difficult. It was easy to spot the patterns and kind of the color differences and just put it all together. There are a handful of pieces towards the end that are all just pink and gold for the different frames, but you know, if you look closely, you can tell the difference between the different frames. And at that point, it really wasn't that many pieces, so it went together really easily. The only really difficult part was the floor, because you can see that there's just a lot of pieces that are just a solid color, but it really wasn't that bad. You know, the pieces are unique enough that you can kind of tell what's gonna go where once you get into it. But this is the first actual Gallison puzzle that I've done, like not a puzzle that's made by Gallison, but kind of branded differently. This is the first like Gallison branded puzzle, and I really liked it. I think the design is so fun. I love celebrating women in this way, and I think the illustration is really nice. And actually the best part is that it has gold foil, so it's actually shiny, and it is so pretty in real life. All right, next on the list is Dream Clutter by GoodFit. This is a new brand that reached out to me like just before the holidays, asking if they could send me some puzzles to take a look at. And I was just really impressed by the illustrations that they have and the fact that they really feature and celebrate their artists. So they sent me a few puzzles. I did a few of them over Christmas. I loved this one. It was not difficult, but it was so fun. Like, look at how much is going on. Again, just like the first one, you can see that there are a lot of very distinct colors and shapes and textures. And when you get to the background, that's the most difficult part, but they actually have a very subtle texture over the gray background. It's like white lines on a gray background. So even though there are a handful of like almost solid gray colors, there's enough going on that it's pretty easy to just finish it off. And I was just really impressed by GoodFit's puzzle quality. The pieces just feel really nice, and yeah, I loved doing this. I can't wait to get to the other ones from this brand. All right, so next we actually have another one by GoodFit. This is Manifestations of Love, and it's only 500 pieces, which is why it's pretty far up on, you know, on the easier side of this list. The picture is like slightly more risque than I would normally feature here, but I just think it's a really beautiful illustration and I love the diversity within it. I actually did this puzzle on New Year's Eve, trying to stay up until midnight. I started this at like 9 and then I finished it at 11. And at that point I was like, I'm so tired. I was on a Zoom call with my friends. I was like falling asleep for the last hour of the call. I even tried to make it last by doing it without looking at the picture, but you know, since it's only 500 pieces and there are a lot of different colors going on, again, like the colors are pretty well blocked off, it really just didn't take that long. All right, from here, we're starting to get into the like medium level difficulty. This is a puzzle called, what is it called? I don't know what it's called. Oh, here it is, Dream Garden. This is a puzzle called Dream Garden from the brand Lemonade Pursuits. This puzzle brand is all over Instagram. I'd been wanting to try their puzzles for a while. So when they offered to send me some, I was so excited to get them. I actually did this puzzle on New Year's Eve as well. I did it from like the afternoon into the early evening. And then I had to pull out the other one because I was already falling asleep at like 9 p.m. So this one has like a couple big distinct shapes of color, but the background, I guess maybe since I was doing it at night, so I couldn't see the color differences quite as well, that's what made it a little more difficult. But there's a lot of like very similar colors in the background, which is what kind of upped the difficulty a little. Also, a lot of the shapes are much more organic. They're not quite as straight in a grid, so that also makes it slightly more difficult, but it was still totally doable. I loved this puzzle from this brand. One thing I wanted to point out are these really fun, like squiggly piece shapes. They have them in the other puzzle by them that I did over Christmas as well. And I just think it really adds to the like fun and playfulness nature of these puzzles. Fun and playfulness, fun and playful nature. Fun. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. All right, next puzzle. All right, next up we have a puzzle from the New York Puzzle Company called The Night Garden. This one is only 500 pieces, so it didn't take that long, but the reason why it is so far into the list is because there are so many like dark colored pieces. And also you can see that a lot of the flowers are very similar colors. So sorting all of that out, especially because again, I didn't look at the picture while I was doing it, or did I? Wait, hang on. I'm getting all mixed up. I think for this one, I actually did look at the picture. Scratch that. But since it's, you know, a painted type of texture, everything kind of flows into each other. And yeah, there's a lot of similar colors across the entire thing and a lot of very dark pieces. And also the New York Puzzle Company puzzles have a random puzzle shape. Not totally random. There are still a lot of pretty traditional shapes mixed in, but it's not on a full grid like a normal type of puzzle. And so I think having these random shapes makes it slightly more difficult. All right, this next one is actually the first puzzle that I did over Christmas, and I took it apart before I had the idea to do this video. So unfortunately, I don't have nice close-ups of this one, but I'll be popping all the photos on screen from when I was working on it. So this is called Urban Planning. It is by Ebu. And just like all of Ebu's other types of puzzles, it is just a beautiful illustration with lots of color, lots of texture. Since this was the first puzzle that I did over Christmas and I was just so exhausted and so tired, I like didn't want too big of a challenge. I just kind of wanted to turn off my brain and just go for it. So I did this one while looking at the picture, which definitely made it easier than if I hadn't looked at where everything was. But there are just a lot of like small sections of different colors and different textures. So it was slightly slower going than the earlier puzzles that I showed, but super fun. I just love puzzles like this with lots of texture, lots of different things to be looking at. So yeah, I really, really loved this one. All right, we've made it to the second pile of puzzles. So this one is Spring Begins by Lemonade Pursuits. And this might be like my favorite puzzle that I did out of all of these. You guys know that I don't glue my puzzles, I don't hang them up, I always take them apart. But this is exactly the type of artwork that I like to hang on my wall. So I'm thinking I might leave this one together in sections in the box and then at some point pull it out again and maybe I'll hang it up. This is like a gradient puzzle taken to the next level because you have, you know, two very distinct halves of color and each one kind of has a gradient within it. But it is a painting, so there's lots of different random splotches of color going on, and then this center part is just wild with all of the colors. So getting started was actually fairly difficult. You know, like I tried to start with the big sections of like just plain yellow and plain orange and plain red. And it took a little while to get going, but once I got the feel for the pieces and I had obviously fewer pieces left to work from, after that it went together pretty easily. This is like the exact level of challenge that I love for my puzzles. And the colors are so bright. This is my like perfect favorite color scheme. So yeah, I'm in love with this puzzle, loved doing it, and maybe I'll actually put it on my wall someday. Oh, just to give a shout out, the artist is Susan Nethercote, and I'll definitely have to look up more of her work because I think this is so beautiful. All right, next we have another escape puzzle from Ravensburger. They sent this one to me at the same time as the one that I did on my channel before, and I decided to hang on to it until Christmas so that I could put it together and then send a photo of it to my sister in New Jersey and we could work out the escape puzzles together. So even though we couldn't be in the same place over the holidays, you know, we could still work on puzzles together. I think that this one was so fun for that. So I'm not gonna show a full close-up of this one because I don't wanna ruin what is different from the picture on the box. The reason why this one is so high up is because in the escape puzzles, there are differences in the puzzle from the picture because you have little puzzles within the puzzle. If you watch my video about them, you'll understand what I mean. So I was going into this one like sort of blind, like I kind of had a feel for where things were, but also this puzzle is very, very dark. So that definitely upped the difficulty because I couldn't really see what was going on for a lot of it. Here's a little hack that I came up with. If you're working on a really dark puzzle, just turn on the flashlight on your phone and then you can, you know, put that where you're working and you can see all of the details way more easily. So I was hopeful that with two of us working on the escape puzzles and without like being under pressure from being on camera, I was hopeful that we would solve them entirely on our own. That was not the case. We did end up having to get some hints, but we solved some of the puzzles and we got there in the end, and it was really fun to do over the phone with my sister. So if you have access to like good lighting and a high quality camera where you can take photos of all of the like mini puzzles within the puzzles, because some of them are pretty dark, so you would need something better than like a phone camera. If you can do that, this is such a good activity to do with family over Zoom and, you know, on the phone. All right, so now we're getting into the puzzles that are actually pretty difficult. This one is Eating Outside by Ibu. And just look at all of those reds and oranges and pinks. It is so many very similar colors. Even the parts that aren't like solid orange, like this tree up here or this tree, or even like the dog, the textures are just fairly difficult to do as a puzzle. So I wouldn't say I struggled with this one, but it definitely took me longer than some of the other puzzles. Also, with this diamond floor that they have, all of the angles just makes like a really difficult piece of the puzzle to put together. But I think it was really fun. It was nice to do something a little more difficult after doing some easy ones for a while. I will say that you need to do this one in daylight or with really good overhead lights, because a lot of the colors are so similar that you just have to be able to see the difference between them, or else you won't get anywhere with this puzzle. All right, so this one wasn't technically a Christmas puzzle. I did it just the other day after I had already been back to work for a few days, but I still wanted to include it. So this is Flamingo Sunset, and I kind of put this one off for a while because I was really intimidated. And it was difficult, don't get me wrong, but it was doable because you can see that the picture is broken up into very distinct sections. Like you have the sky, you have all of the flamingos like crowded together in the background, and then you have all the flamingo legs in the water, and then you have the sky reflection. So each section was difficult, but it was as if you had like three 300 piece puzzles that all interconnect, that you just had to sort out from each other. So in that sense, it was more doable than if, you know, this texture had been over the entire thing. Also, I just love pink. I think the colors on this are so pretty. If I was one to hang up puzzles on my wall, I think this would definitely be a contender because I think the photo is really fun. I love a good flamingo. All right, we have made it to our top three most difficult puzzles. The next one is Celebrate Pride, also by Betterco. And you can tell just by looking at the picture, there is so much going on. There are so many different pops of color all the way across this puzzle. I had to look at the box for this one. Like, if I hadn't looked at the box, it would have taken me the entire Christmas break. Since it is an illustration in this kind of, you know, very clean, blocky style, a lot of the exact same colors are repeated throughout the image. So that makes it a little more difficult to separate out the different, you know, colors and sections that you need. I decided to start with just pulling out all of the green and just filling in all of the pops of green. And then from there, I could kind of find different distinctive areas to pull. But yeah, this one was really hard. There are a lot of very small sections and it's all scattered all over the image. But I will say one thing that I really like about Betterco is that the piece shapes are very distinct. So you never have an issue with pieces seeming to fit where they're not gonna go. And you can use the shape of the piece to kind of picture what piece you're looking for. All right, so taking the number two spot is the biggest puzzle that I did over Christmas. This is the 1500 piece Disney Villains puzzle from Seiko. It is in this kind of stained glass type of style. And when they originally sent it to me, I was like, this will be so easy. You know, it's all gridded out. There are very distinct sections of color. I'm gonna do it without looking at the box. It's gonna be great. Cut to, you know, getting halfway through the edge and then admitting defeat and looking at the box for the entire rest of the thing. So the thing that makes this puzzle so much more difficult than I originally thought is the exact same thing as what I just said. Because it is an illustration in this style, they use the exact same colors across, you know, the entire board. So I started by pulling out all of the sections of white, and it definitely went way faster looking at the box and knowing where all of those different sections were going to go, rather than just having them floating around and trying to build it out around them. And also each different card, which I had originally thought, you know, I could kind of make the grid and then just fill in each card. But the way that I did it was separating out each color individually. And since there are so many different colors and like gradients in each card, I was kind of just working all over the board. But I love a good 1500 piece puzzle. It was so fun to work on one that took a little bit longer than some of the others. You know, this was like a 2-day project instead of a 1-afternoon project. And yeah, I had so much fun with this one, even if it ended up being a little bit more of a challenge than I originally thought. And here we are, the most difficult puzzle that I did over Christmas. This one was honestly a little bit of a surprise to me that it ended up taking the top spot. This is Liberty Rainbow by Ebu. And you know, this middle section of this woman with the flag, totally doable. Went together without a problem. But then you end up at like the last third of the puzzle and it is just solid black. Also, Ebu's piece shapes, they, you know, you don't end up putting pieces where they don't end up belonging, but visually they all look very similar to each other. So it's not even like the Betterco ones where you can kind of use the crazy piece shapes to figure out what piece you're looking for. For this one, I literally had to immediately separate all of the black pieces by shape. And then for a lot of it, I was just literally trying every single piece one by one to see what would fit. I got there in the end, but it was definitely slow going for the last third there. And I was actually thinking about doing an entire video just about like different tips for putting together very, you know, like solid colors like this, or like very similar textures across a large area. So I think separately I'll talk about some of my tips for how to do that. But yeah, those were all of the puzzles that I did over Christmas. I would say that was a very productive Christmas break. I listened to so many podcasts. It was so great. Oh, one more thing. If you follow me on Instagram, well, number one, if you follow me on Instagram, you would have already seen all of these puzzles. So follow me on Instagram if you want to keep up to date with all of the puzzles that I'm doing outside of what I'm filming for the videos. And number two, if you follow me on Instagram, you know that I was worried that this puzzle was missing a piece, and in a lot of the photos you can see that it's missing a piece. I am happy to report that I found the piece. It was not Ebu's fault, it was entirely my own fault. I dropped a piece and it like blended in with my floor, so I couldn't find it for a while, but I found it and the puzzle is complete. All right, so since you have made it to the end of this video, here is your reward. You get a fun little montage of me taking apart pretty much all of the puzzles. As I said, I think I'm gonna keep together this Lemonade Pursuits one, but yeah, everything else I'm taking apart. A lot of these I'm gonna put into my donation pile because I don't think I'll be doing them again. So I'm ready to undo all of this work so that others can enjoy these puzzles as well. All right, let me just, you know, look at all of this hard work for another minute and cue the montage. I hope you liked those little quickfire mini reviews of all of these different brands. I had a great Christmas break. It was so nice to spend like 2 weeks doing nothing but jigsaw puzzles. And now I'm back to work doing jigsaw puzzles, but in front of a camera. So if you want to get any of these puzzles, you know, maybe you are making a little shopping list as you watched, I'm gonna have links to everything right down below. So I'd love to know in a comment, have you done any of these puzzles and did you find them, you know, easier or more difficult than how I described? Or if you haven't done any of these puzzles, which one would you most want to try? So your code word for the comments, I think will be, I'm just gonna grab this one off the top, will be rainbow. So happy puzzling. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video.